Hey guys, it's Franco. My IT and cybersecurity journey. As you can tell, I've been keeping a secret from you guys right here. There's a baby on the way for me. And if you can't tell on the screen, I passed my LPI Essentials certification to Linux Essentials certification. And this video might be a bit long, because I want to get into quite a bit of other things. But what did I use to pass the certification? Well, thank you for asking. We go over on to YouTube. There's a wonderful man by the name of Sean Powers, LPI Essentials. And he has this right here, the LPI Linux Essentials exam prep. I'm probably going to link this down in the description below. That and this wonderful book right here, Linux Basics for Hackers. This book was amazing. I've had this book sitting on my bookshelf for quite a while. I always told myself I was going to go ahead and read it. Never got to it. I haven't finished it yet, but getting right to about chapter 9. Up to chapter 11 gives you a lot of knowledge. A lot of useful knowledge on bash scripting as well. So yeah, Sean Powers and Linux Basics for Hackers, and of course, can't forget Obsidian Notes. You'll pass. And there's other resources on YouTube if you look up LPI Essentials exam. There's a couple of videos on there. I'm not gonna get into that right now, but there's some videos on there that will really help you in the exam, if you know what I mean. Anyways, so what do I want to talk about besides that? Well, I know that mainly this channel has been, me uploading videos, helping you guys pass WGU classes through my experience. And I hope I've been able to provide value to some of you out there, helping you accelerate a little bit, to passing your classes. Because at the end of the day, when you accelerate, you do end up getting a bigger bang for your buck in terms of, how much you pay, right? So, I mean, a semester at WGU costs about a little over 4 grand, WGU themselves estimates that, you'll only do like 4 classes or however many they assign you. So if you end up going over that, I mean, you're saving like thousands in the long run. And pre-gaming with Sophia and stuff like that is really the smart way to do it. I originally wanted to challenge myself to try to finish this degree simply through WGU, but my issue has been calculus. I have about 7 weeks left in the semester, but we'll see if I can if I end up passing it. But after that, the main thing I want to get down to is I don't think the future of this channel is going to be only WGU videos. I think I'm at a point in time where I think I'm going to take a break from WGU and use what I've learned so far and actually go out and apply it. Because I don't want to be accelerate. The issue with accelerating classes is you get so wound up in, I need to finish this as quickly as possible. I need to do this as quickly as possible. And you memorize all this information and you just forget it right after that exam, right? You literally, I don't know if this happens to anybody else, but when you finish the exam, has anybody else felt like this? When you finish the exam, you feel like a release, like, And it's not like a relief, like a sigh of relief. It's more of like you just like release everything you learned, and then you don't even think about what you've learned. You don't actually go out and apply it. So I think that is one big issue that as years come, that's going to be a big issue with WGU's way of learning. And I think people will notice that. I think WGU grads have a higher chance to succeed because most of them are self-motivators and self-starters, self-learners. So we tend to just figure shit out, and I think that's probably the greatest skill we have. But not all of us are like that. And some people are going to struggle more than others. So what am I doing now, you may ask? Well, I'm going to take a break from WGU. I'm probably going to end up doing, if I don't end up passing calculus, I'm probably going to end up doing calculus and at least four or five other classes at one of the four S's, which is Sophia, Sailor, you know, everybody talks about them, to save myself some money in the long run. But I want to start developing my career now to put myself in a better position due to that. Because it's a big responsibility, man. And, you know, I'm so grateful for the job that, you know, started with this channel, which was an IT support technician. You know, and then I got promoted to a field services technician, and you know, I pretty much do like administrate that. They don't, you know, I don't have that role, but at an MSP, like, you're kind of short staffed, so you're gonna end up doing administrator things most of the time. And I've learned a lot about myself in this last year. You know, I look back on the year, and the year went by like that. You know, it went by in a flash. So I think going forward, I'm gonna put school on pause and I'm gonna focus more on. I'm still gonna do educational content for you guys. But I'm gonna focus more on developing myself and my skill set to reach a higher level. Because I want to. I feel like I've learned enough just in this term alone, too. The scripting and programming foundations class was amazing. I mean, the way they explained everything really clicked with me. And, you know, I found myself, you know, when I'm writing a bash script that I learned from this, I found myself going back and looking at, you know, the notes I took on if loops, if else statements, all that stuff, man. And I really want to be able to remember that, so I need to go and apply it. And I think I'm gonna, you know, I'm gonna do that and see where it takes me, demonstrating what I've learned so far. Because I think that's what's important. That's what people forget. Yes, you do need a degree to get a job, but the tech world is a bit different. You don't. You let me correct. Let me restate that. You don't need a degree to get a job. What you need to be able to do is be able to show what you've learned. That is the most important skill in tech. That's why there's kids out here, people out here getting that have been in the industry without degrees for years. People who hold really high positions, make a lot of money in tech without a degree. That is possible, but it takes a lot of work. But I think the most important thing is being able to showcase what you've learned through projects. And I want to focus on that, because I feel like I've learned a lot more than most people, and I've put in the work in the past year, and I think it's time I start showcasing that so I don't forget everything I've learned. So that's it. Just kind of wanted to put that out there. I know most of you probably won't even watch the video up to this point, but I really appreciate it if you did. And I want to try to start collaborating with some of you guys more. But that's all. Thank you guys for watching as always, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.